everybody. My name is Miriam Intratar. I am Special Collections Librarian for Rare Books and Documentary Photo Archive at Alden Library at the Mond Center for Archives and Special Collections. I'm here with renowned photojournalist Lynn Johnson, also a graduate of the VisCom program here at Ohio University, and to be recipient this weekend of the university's Medal of Merit. Extremely excited to have Lynn here, and extremely excited also to be standing in this sort of experimental space that we have created. It is a non-exhibit, an unexhibit, called Lynn Johnson, The Photographer's Process, and it's meant to be sort of an interactive journey through Lynn Johnson's process as a photographer, focusing on the pre-digital period and using the materials in her collection, which we hold at the Mond Center, to introduce people both to the sort of intensity of her process and also to the scope and extent of the collection, which we and which Lynn very much want students, faculty, and other university community members and researchers in general to be coming to us and using and interacting with the physical materials. And so this is meant to sort of start to create that experience for visitors. So that's why we're here. Thank you, Lynn, and welcome.
Thank you.
I wonder if you would speak very briefly about your process as it's shown here and how correct or not correct we might be, and how it's changed with the shift to digital.
So, first of all, this exhibit feels very true to life. I actually love that you thought about the fact that photography for most of its history has had a physical form. We use film and chemistry and producing negatives and slides and prints. So, you can actually see the process here, how it's progressive through the photography and the selection process, editing process. And then in this case, Miriam has chosen some diaries, books, an actual file, a drawer that where the files are living, and I really think that this part of photography, which I've been shooting for 40 years or so this was at least 30 plus of it, and I think the move to digital has changed photography in fairly profound ways. And I actually still shoot a little bit of film now and then, but I'm mostly digital, just the pressure of time.
What do you miss most about this period and this process?
I think I miss the way that film reinforces curiosity, that you have to be in hot pursuit of the story and of the best image to communicate the story and the relationship. And then you never really know if you have succeeded. And so you have to just work for the deepening of the story. You can't look at the back of the camera and say, because first of all, you don't. You don't know. And second of all, I think that's not really a very good attitude to have anybody. We never fully understand another person or another situation. And so film keeps one curious and maybe a little insecure and in pursuit of something important.
So you just met with a class of students, and one thing I heard you say that really struck me was something about how isn't photography still physical? Mm-hmm. And I wondered if you could just talk a little bit more about that.
Well, I think it's one of the art forms. Well, first of all, art forms have its physicality, but when you're telling the story of another person, you really have to physically be in their life. And you have to move. You have to look for the best position and angle and perspective and going to choose intimacy and live very close to that person, or I'm going to choose distance and disconnectedness and far away. And so as a photographer, in this way I pursue it, I'm always moving, I'm almost never still. And that's, it's like grazing.
I have a ton more questions, but hopefully we can speak again later. But we really want people to come to this space. The display will be up for the rest of the semester through early December. And again, the idea is come in, touch things. We have lens, light table with reproduction slides and negatives. And you're welcome to look at everything, move them around, organize them how you see fit. And then we also have a response wall. We're lucky to have a whiteboard wall in this space. People have already written some pretty amazing things. We've asked people to respond to what they sort of see and think and feel about lens process, but also to write about your own creative and professional processes. And I know for me, creating this has been a very useful exercise. I really struggle with writing processes, and so thank you for giving us this opportunity.
Thank you. Great honor.
Thank you.